Hey, what's up? Alex here. If you have problems with your home Wi-Fi, or if you just moved to a new place and is looking to do up your home network, for me, there are only two ways that I recommend. I mentioned this before in my video. If you are good with networking stuff, you can go with the AP plus AC solution, but this is a separate topic which I will not go into it in this video. So for most people, the easiest and most straightforward way is to go with a Wi-Fi mesh system to extend the coverage to the entire house. So today, I am finally going to talk about AC+AP, but you don't need to be a networking expert because what I'm going to share with you is a very simple AC+AP setup, which is not very common here. I'm not talking about those ceiling-mounted AP which you see in a lot of public places, which you have to run a bunch of cables on top. This is what I'm talking about. This is the AP. AP stands for access point, which is going to give you all the Wi-Fi you need in the room. Look at how sleek and clean looking this is. The whole setup typically requires a number of components. The AP that I've just shown you needs to be connected to an AC. AC stands for access controller. That's why it's called AC-AP setup. To power up both the AC and AP, you will need something called a PoE switch. And PoE stands for power over Ethernet. Basically, it's having your network cable to double as a power cable so that you don't need to have those power adapters. And you also still need a router, and that router needs to be connected to your ONR or ONT from your ISP, which is like the modem. So components-wise, it seems like there are quite a few, but device-wise, all you need is just one single device like this over here. This is a 3-in-1 that combines a router, a PoE switch, and AC, all in one. This is a model from TP-Link, ER7212PC. This costs $409. The AP I have here is the EAP650-Wall that costs $172 each. So let's say we need three of these AP. So the total cost for the entire setup is around $925. Later on, I'll take a mesh system with a similar price from TP-Link as well and give you a comparison in terms of the speed you get. Okay, full disclosure, this video is not sponsored by TP-Link. I only borrowed these devices from them because I know they have such a solution. All I want is to let y'all be aware that such a thing exists in the market and is actually super popular in places like in Hong Kong and China. You know, some of the condo projects there, the developer actually installed these in all the units. Okay, the toughest part of the installation should be how to install this kind of AP. I've already installed one in my gym room, so I will quickly show you how I do it. Don't worry, this is super safe. You don't even need to shut down all the power. Look at the back of the AP first. You have a connector for a network cable. Remove the front cover plate and you see two screw holes. Remove the cover plate of your existing point. Usually the opening is below. Detach away the cover from the cable inside. Okay, so the idea is to have this cable connect to the back of the AP. To do this the proper way, you have to remove this whole thing here and use the RJ45 crimping tool to attach the connector. I'm going to use the easy way out by getting a super short cable to connect both ends. This is a 25cm Cat6 cable from Ugreen. You want to look for thin cables and small connectors so that you have enough space to stuff everything inside. Simply just screw in the AP and cover back the front plate and you're done. If you want to do wired connections to your devices, there's a port below that you can use. In case if you're wondering whether you can use a LAN splitter here to increase the number of ports, Linus Tech Tips did a video to talk about this if you're interested. TRDR is to just get a 5-port switch like this. This is really very cheap. I can connect to my PC, PS5 and TV. Next, inside your DB board, you will place the 3-in-1 router here. If you prefer to mount on the wall, you can also do that. Take the cable from your ONR or ONT and plug it into port 3, which is the WAN port. Then for all your rooms, you have from port 5 to port 12, total of 8 ports for you to use. A few minutes later, you will see the lights blinking on those ports that you have connected. Blinking means there is activity going on. Everything should be okay and you can go ahead to configure your Wi-Fi settings. If you want to compare how easy it is to set up AC-AP versus their Deco Mesh, Then, of course, mesh is always going to be easier because the product is designed for consumers. Everything can be set up within a mobile app, and within minutes, it's done. AC+AP, on the other hand, is always considered to be more as an enterprise business solution, where you have more management controls to all the network settings and every single component, ports, and the connected devices. This even has cloud access. This means that if you install this at your parents' house, you will still be able to control it anywhere via internet, help to troubleshoot, fix the network without having to go down to that place. I will now do some speed tests at a few spots in the house based on one AP and show you the result. First, let's do one that is directly facing the AP with no obstacles. This should give me the max Wi-Fi speed I will get. Second spot, let's have the signal try to go through a thick cement wall in front of it. I expect to get around half the speed from the first spot. Third spot, let's do it in the common toilet with the door closed. I'm also curious what kind of speed I'll be getting here. Looking at these speed test results, you can see a huge drop in speed at the second and third spot. The reason is because when I'm at the first spot, I'm connected to the 5 GHz band. But when I moved to the second and third spots, the connection got shifted to the 2.4 GHz band. So if it's within the room itself, the speed is very good. However, when it needs to penetrate walls, then the signal strength becomes weak. But for smart home devices sitting on the 2.4 GHz network, those will be fine. Okay, so you must be curious how the speed compares with a mesh system from TP-Link as well, with roughly the same amount of money. What I'm going to use is the Deco X80. The price of a 3-node pack together with an 8-port switch is around the same price range. Note that this is an AX6000 dual band, and the AP that I've installed is just AX3000. So I would kind of expect to have a better speed with the mesh. The reason why I don't want to use an AX3000 mesh for the comparison because I think it's more practical to compare based on the same budget. I'll place the mesh node at the same spot as the AP, doing a wired mesh backhaul, and then do all the speed tests at the same spot as just now. And here is the average speed I got from all the three spots. For the first spot, the difference in speed I would say is simply because of the different specs from the AP and mesh. But over at the second and third spot, the mesh system clearly wins hands down. I could potentially do some tuning on the AC and AP to get some improvement, but I doubt it will get anywhere close to what the mesh is giving. Mesh is also just so good in an indoor setting, while AP is designed for big open areas. Alright, so based on the speed test result, you can more or less conclude that mesh is most likely going to give you a better performance over this AC+AP using the same amount of budget. So if I were to give you my recommendation of when to use which, I would say my number one reason why I would pick the AC+AP is because of the aesthetics. It just looks so much better without the cable to the mesh node. You also don't need to find a space to put it and worry about spoiling the entire room decoration. AC+AP is fundamentally an enterprise business solution. So the way the devices are built focus more on the overall stability and management capabilities. So it's more common to see people using AC+AP for home network versus small companies using mesh Wi-Fi in their office. In terms of scale, mesh will make more sense if you just need 2 or 3 nodes maximum. For AC and AP, I would say you are looking at starting at 3 AP minimum, then able to go up as many as what the AC can support. If you are looking for cheaper options, you can go Taobao search. They have smaller models like this that I think should work in Singapore as well. Then of course, no warranty here and everything is probably in Chinese. But let's say if your house is not wired and you don't intend to get it wired because it's a rental apartment or various reasons, then basically the only options you have is going with a wireless mesh network. If not, AC+AP and mesh are the only two solutions I recommend for a good Wi-Fi coverage for the entire house. If you are looking to buy a Wi-Fi 6 mesh system now, you can go check it out here. It's one of my most popular videos I did. This year, there are already some Wi-Fi 7 mesh systems that have already launched. I'll be doing a comparison video, so stay tuned if that's what you are interested. With that, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!